Bees have been busy for millions of years now, and they're not about to stop anytime soon. Foragers still return from the fields with nectar, while guard bees still watch and wait. There's treasure in this beekeeper's hive, and all are sworn to protect it with their lives. Suddenly, an intruder comes flying in, a wasp hoping to capture a bee and feed it to its hungry grubs. The battle begins in earnest. The wasp is larger, but the bees make up in numbers what they lack in strength. They sting the invader relentlessly. For the individual bee, it's a suicide attack. The bee's stinger and part of its abdomen will be ripped from its body when it pulls away. But the defense of the colony is the only thing that matters. Paralyzed by venom, mortally wounded, the wasp is unceremoniously dragged to the edge of the hive and dumped. Just an ordinary day of birth, death, sex, and violence. And it's not even noon yet. Ah, spring. After a long winter, it's time to get outside and to drink your fill of nectar. If you're a honeybee, this is your field of dreams. Bees get almost all of their food from flowers. Attracted by the bright colors and sweet smells, the bee thrusts its body and long straw-like proboscis deep inside the flower and sucks up the sugary nectar at the bottom. Pollen, the bee's source of protein, is also on the shopping list. While the bee is gathering nectar, pollen collects on the small hairs of its body. To carry it safely, the bee stows it away in sacs on its hind legs. A bee can carry its own weight in pollen and nectar and still fly, barely. Some food will fuel the bee's own activity, but most will be saved for the communal hive. As soon as they return, the foragers prepare to unload their cargo. Other workers are waiting to help them. A full load of nectar fills nearly half of a bee's abdomen. The foragers bring up the nectar from their stomachs into their mouths. Household bees then suck it out. As the nectar is passed on from one bee to another, it's processed by enzymes in the bee's body. The nectar is then tipped into storage cells. It takes about 5 days for it to thicken and ripen into honey. When the process is complete, the honey cell is sealed with wax, like a lid on a jar, to be opened when needed. Pollen is stored separately in other cells. Later, it's mixed with honey and used, for the most part, to feed the young. The bees pack it down to make room for the next load, and the next. Together, the dark pollen cells and lighter honey cells make up the bee's pantry. The search for nectar and pollen lasts as long as the light does. The flowers are not just being charitable. By luring the bees, they get them to carry pollen from one blossom to another. A flowering plant can't reproduce unless it gets pollen from another flower of the same type. Without bees, most would die. When a scout bee discovers a rich new source of food, it must tell the others how to get there. This is the waggle dance. Pay close attention. To learn the location of the nectar, watch how fast the bee waggles its body. Listen to the sounds it makes, and remember the speed, direction, and number of patterns in the dance. It's the bee's version of a map. Directions are always given in relation to the sun, to the right of it, the left, or dead ahead. Success at last. Nice nectar. It takes the nectar from 5 million flowers to make 1 pint of honey. Each bee may visit hundreds of blossoms in a day and work a 12-hour shift. They make about 10 journeys in a day, with each trip lasting roughly an hour. Today, just like yesterday, there is no rest for the weary. Most worker bees live for only about a month. They simply wear out. There's a constant need for replacements, so feeding and raising the young takes up much of the hive's energy. There are 3 types of bees here: the female workers, the male drones, and the queen. The workers are the smallest, but they do all the work of the hive, from nursing the young to foraging. Every few days, they take on a new job, running through all of them in the course of their lives. The drones, who are medium-sized, mate with the colony's queen, their one and only job. They don't forage for food, they don't even have stingers to protect themselves.